not take any interest in trying verbally all, speak to him or yell at him or fight him, still kept on in front of everyone. His wife steadily cuts out his child with no parent around and belittled her in front of everyone. The next day, he did apologize to all the students or all the kids in the huddle, but he never addressed us. We were told by Josh that after Monday, we are no longer to speak to the coaches. Parents are not allowed to communicate with them. And I've never heard of that before in my life. We are not allowed to speak to them. If there's any other problems, they're going to call the police. Whoever's involved is going to get arrested, and they're going to disband the team. The only thing that I have a problem with is those children haven't done anything wrong. They have not done anything to deserve to not be able to play the rest of the season due to an adult who does not have to control themselves. And I can see that this is a one-time incident. Yes, everybody has a problem sometimes. Sometimes, you know, you're nervous. I completely understand that. But if you can't be humble enough to come to the parents and apologize or to conduct yourself in a manner to where children should look up to you, then I feel like you shouldn't be out there. I wanted to petition because I didn't feel it was fair for another incident to happen and the children have to suffer and then Coach McDonald no longer be able to coach. I feel Coach McDonald's a good coach. I just don't think that he should be out there. I don't know what's going on. I really don't care about my business. It's just he needs to set a better example. I don't want anybody to have to suffer because of an adult problem. And like I said, he's been disrespectful to the parents as a whole. He doesn't speak to us. When he does, it's in a very rude manner. He never wants any advice. He always is very quick to anger. He's taken parents to the side, including this man here, and talked to him about letting his son be rude to Coach McDonald's son. The rest of the kids on the team can be running, doing leg lifts, doing warm-ups for 30 minutes. Son is sitting there doing nothing. But yet, if we say anything to him, he's quick to anger, and we cannot. I mean, you don't want to approach him because you're worried that you're going to do something that's going to cause pain, and you don't know what it is, whether it's yelling or he's just going to try to fight you. That's just how it comes off to everyone out there. And I just feel like maybe there's a better way to resolve this other than waiting for something else to happen in front of those children and then do this.
I just want to say one thing that I have spoken to Josh about what he has told you, and the team will not be disbanded and not get to play. You know, if something was to happen with the coaching situation, you know, there's plenty of more volunteers that would step in, and so you don't have to worry about the kids not getting to play football.
Okay, that is my number one.
Good coach. where the kids learn to play football. All it is about learning to play football and enjoying playing football. It ain't winning or nothing like it. And I've heard it from the parents, and the council's talked about it, and I wish Josh would have been here tonight, but I think as a member of the council, we need to call Josh in at our next workshop and take further action on this. As I see it, it's been going on, and until we get the serious problem, the sheriff's department involved out there, a parent jumps on the coach jumps on one of the parents out there, and then all the kids get scared, don't play, we take action, take care of this. And it's happened before out there, and this is not the first time. This won't be the last time until the city council does something.
So we're going to, we'll discuss it further at the workshop with the rec director.
Yeah, I suggest we take a recommendation. He needs to be seated. He's going to put involved in that.